ain't your cloth. You ain't, that ain't no sauce. I can see the noodles made for poodles. I'm thinking about the LaFerrari coupe. 1.8, the option is the roof. Greens is a secret to the youth.
Everyone, I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Anticipation is mounting for today's game, and we've got two quarterbacks looking to make an impact. It's Ryan's Falcons going up against Rivers' Chargers.
And Larry, I thank you. We are at the home of the Chargers for the next 4 years as you get a look at the StubHub Center here in the LA suburb of Carson. The scene a moment ago, unlike any other in the NFL for a lot of years. The crowd here in Carson might be half the size of a normal NFL stadium, but they are twice as loud as their Chargers get set to face off with Matt Ryan and the Atlanta Falcons. And the decision to bring it out will cost. About 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Rivers on first down. Finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 17 yards for the Chargers there as they've got themselves a first down. Now the offense lining up first and 10. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll run. This is Melvin Gordon. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. It'll go as a gain of 11 at a Charger first. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only the control and things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Throwing Rivers. Caught on the left side by Benjamin. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Could be 4-down territory even if they don't get this, but they need just a few inches here on third. Rivers now. He's by himself, Keenan Allen. And for a Charger touchdown. Keenan Allen, 41 yards. And the Chargers have taken a first quarter lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted, was it an audible, or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. So the D-line's going to spread out. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got five here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
A phrase we said a lot last year, Ryan DeJones for a Falcon first down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get serious.
A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. This is Freeman on first and 10. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. From the shotgun, Ryan fighting to stay upright. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Looks like Ryan's going to stay out there. Indeed, they're going to try for this on fourth down. They'll indeed go for it with Ryan. It's caught. Jones. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back right near the 39. Give him 18 on that one. And it'll give the Falcons a first down. Ryan. Complete to Jones. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. The completion good for three, and it's second down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage looked defensively. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number two. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. And the first play will be a field goal try. This is a 49-yard attempt. Right hash. It. No good. Wide to the left there for Bryant. And this score will stay right where it is. So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, sent this one off target.
The LA Chargers taking over on offense here in a second. They won six of their last seven in 2017. You mentioned earlier, just missing the playoffs. And, you know, who would have guessed that they would have had a rebound like that? Because they started 0-4.
They really channeled what the 1992 Chargers franchise that started 0-4 and ended up 12-4 and won their division. But they came close. What a valiant run. But they ran into our producer, Ben Ramsar's Kansas City Chiefs, in Kansas City late in the season. That one loss out of those last seven, that's the one that kept them out of the playoffs.
Try and run it. Here's Gordon. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. And 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue. A first down throw here for Rivers.
But he does it a high.
And nowhere to get away. Rivers is dropped. Brooks Reed in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
12. One now. Hurry up.
Now a second down throw for Rivers. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down. Then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back. But it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. The play clock's running down to throw Rivers. And that is incomplete.
Well, we quit counting yardage on that one, didn't we? That was truly third and a mile, wasn't it?
It was. I thought they might just go underneath, but they didn't. They wanted to get the first down there.
Yeah, they tried to pick up the huge chunk unsuccessfully. I'm with you. I would have tried to take some yardage just to gain some field position.
He gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Before the possession switches here, I had written down that I wanted to talk about some of the awards this past season in the NFL. We know Brady was the MVP, but Todd Gurley, Offensive Player of the Year.
How about that for a bounce back? Many were questioning whether he had a sophomore slump the season before. Didn't even get to 1,000 yards. Was a dominant force in 2017. How about his teammate Aaron Donald on the defensive side? He took home Defensive Player of the Year award.
Yeah, very impressive. They had both sides of the ball. Sean McVay deserving, I think you would agree, of Coach of the Year.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, what he did for the Rams when they went from last in the league in scoring to leading the league in scoring and winning a division title. And how about the New Orleans Saints? Rookie of the Year, offense and defense. Alvin Kamara on offense, Marshawn Lattimore on defense.
On third down, Devontae Freeman. And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. 6 yards there on the pickup, and it'll be first down Atlanta. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he'll be taken down deep into Charger territory. A big play there, Ryan to Jones. 45 yards. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We'll come back to Southern California after this. On first down, Ryan. Here's Sanu on the catch. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. First down now, but that clock rolling.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie,
And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones, a 2-yard touchdown grab. Now the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. And he puts it through. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Before the offense changes hands here, let's look back at the Super Bowl February 5th. What a game. I know you were there calling it offensively, though. Impressive on both sides.
It certainly was, and let's face it, if you're in Minnesota, it's cold outside, but you talk about the offenses, they heated up in a big way. And how about Nick Foles, the backup quarterback turned MVP, 373 yards, 3 touchdowns, and of course, the big one receiving on the Philly special.
Quite a story. As you and I were talking about off air, it was just a fluid game, not a lot of penalties, just really clean play.
Exactly the type of game the NFL needed for the audiences at home watching the game, and of course, people in attendance. A really well-played game.
A big play there for LA, and even 40 yards. They go back to Gordon here on first down. And some room to maneuver. The 20. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. A big run there. 29 yards and a first. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now Gordon on first down. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Rivers has been through this many times as he'll hustle his guys to the line. They'll try to throw here. Rivers. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. So it's third and long for the Chargers and Rivers after the sack.
Let's go!
And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up fourth down.
This offense really put themselves in a tough spot on first and second down, needing long yardage to try and pick up a first down, and they ended up getting a great run. Explosive, picked up nice yardage. You don't expect to be in this situation on fourth down, but guess what? It all started with what happened on first and second down. Really put them behind the eight ball.
On fourth down, Anthony Lynn says, let's go for 3. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. Here's Clemens. They pass up the 3, fake it, it doesn't work. Falcons taking over on offense in just a second, and, you know, this year ended in disappointing fashion now. Last year was the ultimate version of heartbreak, but if you're a Falcon fan, was this one was tough to swallow as well, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because let's be honest about it. Losing in the Super Bowl, I don't care how you lose, you're in the Super Bowl. You're playing for it all. This team was supposed to be as good or better. Ultimately ended up 10-6, found their way in the playoffs, but didn't get the deep run as they had the year before. So you're exactly right. For Falcons fans, that's a tough one. But this is a team that's built to be good for a long time.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And down he'll go at the 25. We have hit halftime. Still 2 more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter 3.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. Finding some room at midfield. And this one complete to Levine Toilolo. 15 yards through the air and a first down.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense, and reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. And they'll get him down here at about the 42. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On 2nd down, here's Ryan. And it's hauled in by Austin Hooper. And he's going to get this inside the 30. A Falcon 1st down, Ryan to his young tight end Hooper. They go play action here on 1st down. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at 2nd down.
Sometimes we wonder about play calls, but this one made perfect sense to me. He's got the only touchdown that they've scored in this game. Tried to get it to him again on another deep ball.
Here's Ryan. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. Third down here. Well, pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
On third down, Ryan. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Trey Boston. And to the 12. That's where it stops. The return is halted at the 12-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before? Blitz coming, and down he goes.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Second down, Rivers. Benjamin with it over the middle. And able to get it here to about the 16-yard line. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On third down, this is Melvin Gordon. Room here to run. Give him 15 yards on that one and a Charger first down. Well, after an interception, last thing you want to do is go three and out, give the ball right back. They avoided that.
Yeah, you definitely do not want to do that. I remember in college I played with a really big-time player on defense. We ended up getting an interception as we passed the offense coming out. He told him,
you don't pressure brought in. Falcons get there for the sack.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Rivers now on second down. Sets up the screen to Gordon. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. He lost four there, and it's third down. And that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize it is broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the...
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way down to the 40-yard line. A big play there for the Chargers on third down. And even 40 yards. And here comes play number six on this drive. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to go for a big play downfield. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
But depending on the team, they call that an explosive play or a chunk play, the one that they got on the previous one. They tried to go back and get another one, didn't they?
They did, but unsuccessful on that second attempt. A second down throw for Rivers. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And he'll take this across midfield and inside the 45.
Now, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
After the interception, here's Ryan. Looking deep for Julio. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, help force the incompletion.
Yeah, had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
And incomplete here on third down.
But plain and simple, that's the second time today that he's dropped a pass.
And that one, I think, maybe even a little easier than the earlier one that he dropped. Surprising.
Was this game announced as a night game prior to it? Maybe his rhythm was just off. He's got thrown off. He's got to wake up, enjoy the sunshine, and go play.
Some open field here, and a cut to the right, and some open field here, and he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It'll go as a gain of 11 at a Charger first.
I know anytime you watch a team run the ball really well, there's some pinball effect, people bouncing off of each other. There's also some things of beauty in there when you see these nice, explosive, strong runs. And this guy, he knows how to carry the football really well and continually wants the football. Why? He knows the offensive line's going to give him great effort, and he gives great effort himself to finish off runs.
Now Rivers going to give it off to Gordon. And a solid run down inside the 30. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
On second down, they'll run with Gordon. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 12 yards there, and the Chargers have a first down.
Really good, skillful, tough running throughout this contest. Picked up first down after first down. He's got to have a nickname, doesn't he? How about the human first down machine? I think that fits.
From the red zone now, Rivers. And snapped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I didn't get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
No gain there, and it's going to set up 2nd and goal.
And there's a nice stop for the defense. They've had a tough time containing this guy all game long, but maybe they can build a little bit off of that play, a little bit of confidence, a little bit of momentum. Yeah, every now and then you can actually tackle that guy.
They'll try and punch it in, Gordon. And I think they stopped him again. They did at the 1-yard line. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a 3rd and goal. Good play here. And he will get in across the chalk for a Chargers touchdown. Melvin Gordon taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Chargers have taken the lead.
But they decided to run it in and got it done on 3rd and goal. A lot of times that's a passing play.
And the kicker just has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he probably should have stayed in the end zone as he'll muster a return up to only the 14-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Trevor Williams with a pick, and his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line.
Brandon, offensively, this has been a tough day for them. Trying to find a place to throw the football, it's been extremely difficult. I've got to give a lot of credit to the secondary, especially the corners who have had the receivers on lockdown.
And he's got room. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
First seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
He's been busy this afternoon and able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. So they get half of what they needed. It'll be third and six upcoming. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. The Chargers on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This will be third and six. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. To throw is Rivers. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked up by Keanu Neal. And he will score. Touchdown, Falcons. So they go on fourth down. Not only do they not get it, it turns into 6 points the other way. Disastrous.
And many people think you should just go ahead and knock it down in that situation. Turn it over for the offense. But I had a defensive coordinator recently tell me, we see that as a passive play. We don't do that anymore. We want the ball in our hands, and we want to head the other way.
Probably also instinct a lot of times. If you see a lot of green grass ahead of you, go ahead and grab it.
It's the exact right play to do. That's knowing when to break the rules and when to make a play that maybe you hadn't been taught.
And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play. But if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock, or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Charger first. And some room to work. There goes Melvin Gordon. And that's a touchdown as they've broken our tie here in the final minute of the fourth.
Well, any thoughts about overtime have ended at this juncture. That touchdown puts them up 6. I would imagine they'll kick the extra point now and rely on their defense.
Yeah, rely on their defense. So a little bit of time left on the clock here in the fourth, but they got to feel good now. No back out now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Well, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as they'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock. He'll look to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 49. Past the 20. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six. And a
since my early days, I've been stuck in my worldly ways. Propaganda, press, ban the camera, please don't look at me in my face.